Time zones can be a very difficult aspect of web development to understand. There are different time zones all over the world, and most of these time zones are not as logical as you would hope. Every country has a different time, and you want to make sure that you are showing a user in that country the right time. There are some tricky caveats. Not all time zones are exactly 1 hour plus or minus UTC, so storing a plus or minus integer doesn't work. Not all time zones have daylight savings time. And political events can cause time zones to change their offset. Many developers approach this by always storing dates in their database as UTC. Any date going in is converted to UTC on input and back from UTC on display. To calculate time zone offsets, many developers store plus 1 or minus 4 as an offset and put that in their database as an integer. This means that if the country's offset is minus 4.5 hours, then the numeric representation is minus 4.5. This is a decimal, and if you try to put decimal numbers into an integer field, it will be truncated by MySQL, and only the value 4 will be saved. Even storing a decimal number would not help if DST or a time zone change came into effect. The time being displayed to the user would still be wrong by as much as an hour. The more robust way to work with dates and times in PHP is to store the actual time zone in the database and not just the offset. PHP uses IANA time zones, which are an internationally recognized body in charge of handling mapping of these time zones and keeping them up to date.
Let's take a look at some code. At first, this might look like a lot of code, but when broken down, it's pretty simple. On line 3, we have a new datetime object, just as before, using a supported format. We've also specified the second argument of the datetime class, which is an instance of dateTimeZone. This accepts a string with the name of a time zone, and UTC is the one we want here. Next, we clone that date so we can keep a copy of the original. We do this because dateTime is a mutable class. That means the object will change state when we run methods like setTimeZone. So that we can keep a copy, we have to fully clone the object, then work with a brand new version. On line 7, we now use the setTimeZone method on our new copy of the UTC dateTime instance. And the string America New York is a supported IANA time zone name. This will update the local dateTime object to have a new time zone and therefore a new time. Finally, at the bottom of the script, we're outputting two paragraphs with the date and time for UTC and another for the time in New York. Let's have a look at that in the preview. Great, looks like that worked. 1314 in UTC is now showing as 0914 in New York, which is exactly right. All dates should be stored as UTC in the database, but dates should always be displayed to the user in their own time zone. This sounds complicated, but simply means you need to convert from UTC to the local time zone for output, and then convert from the local time zone to UTC on input. Let's go back to our workspace and see what that code might look like. This is basically the same piece of code we had before, we've just swapped things around. Now, it's worth noting that you'll probably take your input from a superglobal, such as a post variable, but for the sake of simplicity, we're going to use just a raw variable here. Now, the rest of this is pretty much the same. We're creating a local date time from the American New York time zone. We're cloning that to make a UTC date time object, and then we're setting the time zone of that to UTC. So now if we run this, it should look exactly the same as before. Perfect, we still got 13 o'clock and we have 9 o'clock right there. By storing the time zone name itself, the various offsets for daylight savings time or geopolitical changes are handled for you. All you then need to do is store all dates in UTC and update them on output. So just remember, all dates are stored in the database as UTC. All users should have a time zone attached to their own account. That time zone should be a valid IANA name. And whenever you output a date, you need to set the time zone of that date to match the user's time zone. Let's try out a few questions on UTC and time zones.